Hello everyone! I'm back! It's been a long time since my last video, my last vlog, sorry, you know, I posted videos but not vlogs. And maybe you've already noticed my beautiful necklace and ring, maybe this, but you probably didn't notice this, because this video is sponsored by Ana Luisa. You know how picky and really selective I am with my sponsors? I never show you anything that I don't really, really, really like, but today I'm super excited because I love Ana Luisa's jewelry. They make very beautiful, high quality, and long-lasting pieces. They are carbon neutral, meaning that they offset 100% of their carbon emissions. They focus on sustainability, and they are very coherent to the packaging. When I received these pieces, the packaging was very, like, minimal. I really liked it. Now, one more thing that I really like about Ana Luisa is that I could find some pieces that look good with my style. Of course they have more like classy and elegant pieces, but I feel like a lot of brands do, but they have some cool pieces that I could adapt to my style. Like the other day I went out for a photo shoot because one of my friends was like, Sonia, you need help with your pictures. You take terrible pictures. I was wearing my hip-hop street style that I really like, and I was wearing these pieces and they looked amazing. So I picked this chain necklace. It's really cute. It says Be You. It was 61 euros. Then I picked this ring here. I like it because it's adjustable, so you don't have to know what ring size you are. Honestly, I have no idea what ring size I am. And then I picked this ear cuff. Okay, I've never had earrings. Never. I don't want to pierce my ears. I don't want to. But I do like this thing because finally I can have my earring. The ring was 77 euros. The ear cuff was 31 euros. So I feel like you can find good pieces for all budgets. So go check out their website. The link is in the description box below. And if you use my code, you get 10% off. Now, today is a normal day in my life, so I'm gonna work. And tonight, since it's my dad's birthday, we're gonna go out to celebrate his birthday. But throughout the video, I really wanna talk about intercultural relationships. Pros and cons, challenges and fun things. But first, I need to work for a little bit, so stay tuned, see you later.
I worked, and then I kidnapped Brian for my questions.
I think these questions are easy, but it all depends on our answers.
Let's go.
Okay, question number one. What was the biggest challenge you faced in the first months of our intercultural relationship?
I was so nervous around beautiful women. So being around her was like a nervous breakdown. It's like probably missing sports. Psych. All right, seriously, there's no outstanding challenge.
In the first few months? Okay, I'll start. The biggest challenge in the first few months was just finding a place to stay, a place where we could like develop our relationship. Because he didn't have a visa to be in Italy, I didn't have a visa to be in America. I have nothing against long distance relationships, but I feel like it's really not me. It's so hard for me personally. We went to Japan so that we could both have a visa and be together and develop our relationship. That was huge.
That's a great answer. That's a great answer. Her answer.
Second question is, now, what's the biggest challenge?
There's no huge challenge now. Like, life's good. Sonia and I have our situation. I guess the biggest challenge now is just like distance from family. Like, that's the obvious one, right? Like, I don't get to see my family every day. I can't just drive down the street and they're there. Luckily, my family is flexible and like they want to come to Italy and they have come a couple times, and I'll go to America sometimes and like we'll make it work. Is it just this constant ongoing struggle? No. Do I miss them? At times, of course, we make it work.
My turn. For me, the biggest challenge now, it's still kind of like related to this. After we made the decision and we decided to live in Italy, this created a lot of like sense of guilt for me, kind of, because I know that he's far from his family, his culture, he's facing a lot of challenges. You know, everybody's always reminding me like, oh, but he's far from friends and family and everything. And I guess I was just feeling guilty. I was feeling bad for him, but that's not good, because if you think about year after year after year, you don't want to feel bad. I'm currently working on this because I want to accept the fact that we made this decision as a couple. You made this decision, nobody forced you, and I'm saying this because I want to convince myself as well. You're happy, and even though you have to face some challenges, this is what you chose. And I shouldn't feel guilty if I have more friends here than you, because of course I grew up here, or if one night I go out with my friends and you're staying home playing Call of Duty with your brother online. Yeah. Question number three, what is something you like about being in an intercultural relationship?
It's, I think, more like stimulating and interesting and just fun. It's not like monotonous, and like maybe it does bring some extra challenges that otherwise we wouldn't face, but overall I like it. And sometimes, like, actually it sounds terrible to say, but sometimes like I'll see or hear like American girls from my culture and I'm like, I'm glad my wife's not American.
Not
as a diss to America, like, but I like that she's not the same as me, I guess. I don't know.
It's, you like, kinda diversity.
Yeah, it's just cool. And like one of my hobbies is like, or interest is like culture and travel and international, and like, so having your wife be like that, it's like you get to indulge in your hobby all the time too.
I'm his hobby. What I like, it's kind of like similar to this, but we have different strengths and weaknesses, not only related to our personalities, but also to our cultures. You know, America is more business, money. Let's develop that part of our lives. And Italy is more like, enjoy the little pleasures of life. And I'm really good at that. I mean, I don't know if I'm that good at it.
Yeah, that's a good point.
But like, I am a little bit, but I feel like you developed my business side. Next question, what's something that annoys you about being in an intercultural relationship? What's something you find annoying?
One thing I find annoying is like, and this doesn't happen too often or anything, but sometimes feeling like the foreigner. You identify as like, I am the foreigner. Sonia is the singer. This person is that. For me, my card is the foreigner, and I don't like being like the foreigner.
I'm not the singer.
Well, I couldn't think of anything else. Like, I don't want people to just be like, the American, l'americano, l'americano, l'americano.
But
like,
you're not.
I'm not saying it happens that often, but I just don't want that. And like, I know also with my Italian accent, like if I encounter any stranger, like the first thing they're gonna be like, it's an American. Which, I mean, it doesn't always annoy me and it's not that big of a deal, but sometimes I would just want to be like one of everyone else.
Me? This happens in every country. I think every country has these people I'm about to talk about. But especially in America, sometimes
Whoa. Let's drop the especially in America comment.
I feel like not everybody, but a lot of Americans.
Are you saying what annoys you about a cultural relationship, or what annoys you about America and what annoys me about Italy?
No,
I answered for, okay. If you wanted me to say something that annoys about Italy,
I can. No, it's intercultural relationship. But I feel like in America, a lot of people think that America is the best country in the world. I feel like they're raised to believe that America is the best country in the world. And I believe that there is no best country. But I feel like a lot of Americans think that I got married to you and now I can start my new, better life in America. That annoys me so much. And it also annoys me that some Italians think that I got married to you because you could give me a green card and we could move to America. It annoys me.
I understand. I guess it's true that in America, Americans tend to think like, America's the best.
Last question. Do you think being in an intercultural relationship has changed you? If so, how?
Let's be honest. Any relationship changes you. So, of course, international, has it changed me? Yeah, duh. It's changed a lot. First of all, yeah, like now I'm here. I have a lot of Italian friends, blah, 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 blah. Like, my lifestyle is different. I could never be like, no. What about you?
I don't know. I think for me,
I think the change is bigger for me, given the living circumstances as well.
True, but I feel like it also changed me because culture goes deep sometimes in the way you think, process things, see the world. It goes deep. And I feel like I always have two points of view. I have my Italian point of view when I talk about something and I think about something, and I have your point of view. And I question my beliefs a little bit more because now I know that a lot of my beliefs come from my culture and not necessarily like, you know, this is the truth.
Yeah. But I have to go, so...
You have to go?
Yeah, I have to clean this.
I'll take a little nap because then I have 3 more lessons. I know, guys, like I'm trying to have a day in my life, but a day in my life where I teach is not that exciting. I edited, I posted, I'm shooting, I'm teaching, I'm cooking, I'm eating.
And I'll see you next time.
I don't usually take naps, but lately since I haven't been sleeping really well, I feel like I need them. And no, I usually don't sleep in my normal clothes, but since I hadn't left the house all day, I was like, might as well.
I actually slept more than I thought I would.
I had a little snack and then I went back to work. And I worked and worked. And since it was my dad's birthday, he came to pick us up to go to a restaurant.
Daddy! Happy birthday!
Thank you so much.
Your English is so good.
Little quiz for my Italian followers. Guess who my dad's favorite singer is?
Si vede niente. Quattro dischi e un po' di whisky. Woo! Mi vendo la vita che non hai.
With this crazy coronavirus, we decided not to do anything crazy, so we went to a big restaurant and we had a traditional fish meal. But yeah, I couldn't have the pasta and rice, but the rest, I had it all, so good.
Okay, we're home and we're tired, so I think we're going to sleep.
See you in the next video.
Subscribe the vlog.
Subscribe!